Students, welcome back to our practical English. Today we are going to talk about C6, organic farming. But I have a little bit review for you for last week. Last week we have our chapter 5. We talk about from the cadet to fighter pilot. It takes lots of time and efforts and training to be from a studentto be a firefighter, a pilot. It's not easy to be one. And today we want to talk about the organic farming. It's an interesting topic. It's good for your body and it's good for our environment. And first of all, I would like to introduce you an expert on this one. She's our panelist, Irene Tsai, and she's a great teacher, and also she's my dear sister. Irene, how are you?
Fine, I'm doing great.
Good.Do you want to say hello to our students?
Hi, students. I hope you enjoy learning English with us.
That's great. We are so happy to have Irene here because she had already tried some of the organic foods.
Yes.
First of all, let me ask you a question. What is an organic food?
Organic foods are basically crops that are grown in the farm organically.They are grown without adding any artificial synthesizer, mm-hmm. or pesticide or weedicider.
Okay.
It means that everything is natural.
Natural.
Yes.
No synthetic fertilizer.
Right.
Or pesticides, whatever.
Yeah,
right?
No weed killer, etc.
Okay. That's great. Have you ever tried some of the organic foods?
Sure, a lot. I tried some...Rice, mm-hmm. Most of them vegetables.
Yes.
And rice, wheat powder.
Eggs?
Or eggs, yeah, okay. Even pork.
Even
and
pork?
Cooking oil.
Okay.
Yes, mm-hmm. A lot.
Yeah, I tried some, but I never tried porks. Yeah. Mm. So how do you like it?
I like them, except the price. The price is much higher.
Yeah, it's more expensive.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
And we will tell you why it's more expensive. And what do you know about organic farming?
Organic farming is a kind of a new kind of agriculture.
Yeah.
And that's that we can talk about in this chapter.
Yes, I think so. That's why we are here to talk about the organic farming. So
yes.
Our students will know more about it.好，现在就让我们进入第一段，我们来谈谈有机的一个农作的方式。The first paragraph, students, would you please read along with me so that you can know how to pronounce these words correctly? Paragraph 1, organic food is a better choice than regularly produced food.
有机食品比一般食物产品是更好的选择。
Because it's better for the environment, people, and animals.
因为它对环境、人们和动物比较有利。
Organic farming is the form of agriculture that relies on techniques such as
有机农业是一种依赖如下技术的一种农业，例如
crop rotation, compost, and biological pest control.
轮作、堆肥和生物防治等技术
To maintain soil productivity and control pests on a farm
来保持土壤的生产力以及控制农场中的害虫的一种农业形式
Organic farming strictly limits the use of manufactured fertilizers and pesticides
有机农业严格控管使用化学肥料和农药。
Okay, students, here we talk about several concepts that they are very important to the organic farming. The first one is the crop rotations. What does it mean by crop rotations here?
Crop rotation means that we grow certain kind of crop, and then after the harvest,
yes.
we change to grow another kind of crop.
Yes.
Just rotate different kinds of crops.
Yeah, students here is just like if you have the carrots And then next time, after you have harvest them, then you will have a spinach. Okay? Then after that, you have another kind of crops.
Mm-hmm.
So it will make your soil healthier because mm-hmm. each different plant, they have a different chemistry or the mechanicals mm-hmm. in the soil.
Or pests,
mm-hmm. yes. So that's why it's healthier to the soil.
Mm-hmm.
And for the compost, what is the compost?
In organic farming, we use compost instead of using fertilizer. Synthetic fertilizer.
Yeah.
We can make the compost by using the kitchen leftover.
Yes, kitchen leftover.
Mm-hmm.
So you should put a barrel.
Yeah, and put it in a barrel.
Yes, you have all the kitchen leftover. Just put there and put the soil, one leftover, one layer
yeah,
of soil.
Right.
Then you can use the compost.
Mm-hmm.
那就是没有什么，就是一个。有机
的
天然的啊，不是一个人工的一个肥料、
mm-hmm.
And the third concept, biological pest control. So it means that you have the pest control by the biological one.
Yes.
Yeah.
Like we use certain kinds of bird、
mm-hmm.
to eat certain kind of insects.
That's right.
Yes.
That's
or
right.
ladybugs, etc.
Yeah, that's great.Students, here we just give you some of the concepts, but we will elaborate a little bit in the following paragraphs. Now let's take a look at the vocabulary first. First one, organic. Adjective.
形容词，是用有机肥料的。
Sue only eats organic vegetables because they are good for her health.
Sue 只食用有机蔬菜，因为它们对她的健康有益。
Number two, farm, noun,
名词，农场，饲养场，畜牧场。
Alan works on a farm.
艾伦在一个农场工作。
Number three, agriculture,
noun, 农业，农耕。
Our economy used to heavily rely on agriculture.
我们国家的经济曾经很仰赖农业。
Number four, technique.Noun,
名词，技术。
Our students need to learn more about English speaking techniques.
我们的学生需要多学学英文口说技巧。
Number five, crop. Noun,
名词，农作物，庄稼。
The heavy rain damaged many crops.
大雨损坏了许多农作物。
Here because.I studied in Canada. So Canada is one of the countries of UK. That's why I got the Jones. I always speak with the Jones. And I will say this as a crop. But in JJ, they will say...
In KK,
yes, they will say it as a
crop.
Crop.
Yes, this is American English accent. We say crop.
Yes. 在英文跟英国的英文跟美国的英文有一点小小的不同，那同学们只要知道这个发音上有一些小小不同，那基本上还是都是英文。好吧 ，Let's take a break now。Students, welcome back. For the first paragraph, we have lots of vocabularies to talk about. Now let's keep on looking at the vocabularies number 6, rotation, noun.
农作物的轮作。
My sister-in-law and I follow the rotation for house chores.
我和嫂子轮流做家事。
事实上 ,rotation 是一个轮流的意思啦。哈那在这边它是指说、土地的一种轮作。所以我们这个句子说我跟嫂子是轮流做家事，她并不是轮流去做一个农作物的农耕。OK， Number seven, compost, noun,
名词，混合物，堆肥。
We make compost by throwing our fruit and vegetable scraps into a barrel.
我们把厨余蔬果丢到一个桶子里，以制造堆肥。
Number eight, biological.Adjective,
形容词，生物的。
Irene is my biological sister.
艾琳是我的亲姐姐。
Number 9, pest, noun.
名词，害虫，有害的植物。
There are lots of pests in his house.
他屋子里有好多害虫。
Number 10, maintain, verb.
及物动词，保养。
Susan maintains her skin very well.
苏珊皮肤保养得很好。
Irene maintains her skin very well too.
Thank you.
You can see that. And now we have a 11, productivity noun.
生产力，生产率。
Our manager was so glad that we had already raised our productivity.
我们的经理很高兴，因为我们的生产率已提高。
Number 12, strictly, adverb.
副词，完全的。仅仅
The car park is strictly for the use of customers.
那个停车场仅供消费者使用。
Number 13. Manufacturer. Verb.
及物动词制造加工。
Toyota manufactures cars.
丰田公司制造汽车。
Number 14. Fertilizer. Noun.
名词肥料。
My plants need fertilizer to grow better.
我的植物需要肥料才能长得更好。
Number 15. Pesticide. Noun.
名词杀虫剂。
Please do not spray the pesticide in my room. I can't stand the smell.
请不要在我房里喷杀虫剂，我受不了那味道。
同学们，这边我们有看到一个 I can't stand the smell. I can't stand 是我受不了，这个也是常用的一个片语。I can't stand you anymore. 我再也受不了你了，所以这是很好用的。Let's take a look at some of the phrases. The first one, rely on.
依赖，依靠。
You can rely on the weather.
这天气靠不住。
Number two,Such as,
例如
I love many fruits such as apples, oranges, and strawberries.
我喜欢很多水果，例如苹果、橘子和草莓。
Okay, we want to talk more about organic farming, not we using the pesticides. So in what way we can do that? Let's read paragraph second.Organic farmers use a wide range of practices.
有机农业运用很多种做法
to prevent pests and diseases instead of using pesticides.
取代农药来防止害虫和疾病。
This includes crop rotation and selection of pest-resistant crops and animals.
这包含轮作，还有选择抗虫性的谷物。
They depend on biological pest control.
他们依靠生物害虫防治
and the use of beneficial organisms to reduce pest populations.
使用对生命体有益的做法来减少害虫的数量。
Examples of beneficial insects include
有益的昆虫例子包括
minute pirate bugs.Big-eyed birds and ladybugs.
例如有微小的海盗虫、绿袖眼和瓢虫。
All of which eat a wide range of pests.
这些都会吃很多种类的害虫。
Okay, students, in this paragraph, we learn about three ways to not using the pesticides. One is the crop rotation. We have already explained that in previous.Paragraph. The second one is a selection of a pest-resistant crop, 就是它能够防治害虫的一种谷物。Do you have this kind of crops here in Taiwan?
I consult with some organic farmers, and they said that in Taiwan, because the weather is warm,
yes.
So almost none of the crops are pest-resistant.
Okay, so none is found in Taiwan now. Maybe in other countries.
Yes.
And what about use animals?
use animals to eat insects.
Yes. Yeah,
such as we talk about the birds, the bugs,
okay.
the snails.
Snails,
yes.
okay.
And chickens.
Okay.
Yes.
Chickens, ducks,
yeah,
right?
That's right.
用各种的生物的方式，用生物去吃一些害虫，所以你就不会那么辛苦，要喷那么多的杀虫剂啊。Okay, let's take a look at the vocabulary 16. Prevent, verb.
动词，防止，预防。
Vitamin E is supposed to prevent aging.
维他命 E 被认为能预防老化。
Number 17, resistant, adjective.
形容词，抵抗的。
This plant is a pesticide resistant.
这个植物会抵抗除草剂。
Number 18, beneficial, adjective.
形容词，有益的，有利的。
It would be beneficial to your company if you hire this management expert.
如果聘请这位管理专家，这对你们的公司会有所注意。
Number 19, organism, noun.
名词，生物，有机体。
There have been no organisms found on Mars.
到目前为止，火星尚未发现有机体。
Number 20, reduce, verb.
及物动词，减少。缩小，降低。
My mother is always trying to reduce expenses.
我母亲一直试图减少开支。
I think every mother is trying to reduce expenses of her family. That's what a mother always does. And now let's take a look at the phrases. Number 3, a wide range of.
各种各样。
There is a wide range of people in that country.
在那个国家有各种各样的人种。
Number 4, instead of.
代替。
Instead of staying at home reading, I would rather go swimming.
与其在家阅读，我宁可去游泳。
Number 5, depend on.
取决于。
Our flight to California tomorrow depends on the weather.
明天我们是否能飞加州，取决于天气。
Students, depends on. It's a very useful phrase. Like I can say to Irene, this time I depend on you for passing the test.
Oh, really?
Yes. And can you give me another example?
How about going a picnic tomorrow?
It depends on the weather.
Yes.
That's good. Okay, students, now let's take a break again. Welcome back, students. Weeds are always a big problem for the farmers.So in our next paragraph, we want to talk about weed management. 就是杂草，我们怎么样去消除它呢？ First, let's look at the paragraph. Weed management is also a great challenge to organic farmers.
杂草管理对有机农夫们来说也是一个极大的挑战。
Weeds can be controlled by grazing.
杂草可以用放牧来控制。
For example, geese have been used successfully to.
举例来说，鹅已被成功的用于。
With a range of organic crops, including cotton, strawberries, tobacco, and corn.
包含棉花、草莓、烟草和玉米等。有杂草的有机作物农田里。
Some rice farmers introduce ducks and fish to wet paddy fields.
有些种稻的农夫采用鸭子和鱼在水田中。
To eat both weeds and insects.
吃杂草和昆虫。
I think it's very creative and very smart to use animals to control the weeds. Mm-hmm. But my question is here is that it can be controlled by grazing. As you know that we have the horse, sheep, or cattle, or cow that they can graze, but can those animals differentiate which one should I graze, which one I shouldn't graze? So maybe they will eat all of them.
Of course, the animals are not that smart. Mm-hmm. They will eat the most tender part.
Okay.
So the way is that we circle the animals in a certain place.
Yeah, okay.
And then after this field is harvest,
okay.
And then you put those animals to that field to graze.
I see.
Yeah.
So after harvest.
After harvest, again.
Okay. Right. 同学们在这边的所谓的放牧呢，是你要等到你收成以后再把这些的动物放进去。OK， 不是把这个你要的东西的还有要用的东西长在那儿的时候，你就把这些鹅啊什么放进去，那你就麻烦大了 ，right？ 那 Let's take a look at the vocabulary 21. Weed, noun，
名词，杂草、野草。
Susan's garden is full of weeds.
苏珊的园子里杂草丛生。
Number 22, challenge, noun，
名词，挑战。
To learn English well in half a year is a big challenge for me.
在半年内学好英文对我来说是极大的挑战。
Number 23, graze.
不及物动词，牛羊等，吃草，放牧。
The cattle are grazing in the meadow.
牛正在牧草上，牧场上吃草。
Okay, now we want to talk about the price for organic farming, and we also want to know why should we encourage more about organic farming. Let's take a look at paragraph 4. Although the money spent on synthetic fertilizers and pesticides decreased,
尽管不使用合成肥料和农药，使有机农耕的成本降低了。
The customers pay higher prices for organic produce.
但是消费者却在有机产品中要花更多的钱。
Partly because organic methods often require more labor.
一部分的原因是因为有机的方法通常需要更多劳力。
It takes more time to produce organic food, and not as much is produced when compared to a non-organic farm.
和非有机农产品相比，它需要花费较长的时间，而且产量也较少。
Organic agriculture should be encouraged and supported.
有机农业应该被鼓励和支持。
Because it is a production system that sustains the health of soils, ecosystems, and people.
因为它是一个维持土壤、生态系统。和人们健康的生产系统。
It combines tradition, innovation, and science.
它结合了传统、创新和科学。
To benefit the shared environment.
让我们共享的环境受益。
And promote fair relationships and a good quality of life.
并促进美好的关系以及优良的生活品质。
Now we learned that why the organic products cost more because we have to have more labor on it. Sometimes we have to hire manpower to pull out the weeds.
Mm-hmm.
And sometimes because the organic foods, they are growing not so fast as they use the synthetic fertilizer.
Mm-hmm.
So that's why it takes more time, more effort to it. And...So that's why customers have to pay more. But it's good because it's good for soil, it's good for people, it's good for our ecosystem.
Mm.
That's why we should support it. Okay, now let's take a look at the vocabulary 24. Synthetic, adjective.
形容词，人造的。
After the car accident, he had a synthetic leg.
车祸后，他得用一个义肢。
Number 25, decrease, verb.
不及物动词，减少，减小。
My father's blood pressure is decreasing.
我父亲的血压正在下降。
Number 26, encourage. Verb,
动词，鼓励。
My mother encouraged me to study in the best university.
我妈妈鼓励我去念最好的大学。
Number 27, sustain, verb,
动词，支持，鼓舞。
How can we sustain our members?
我们该如何支持我们的会员呢？
Number 28, ecosystem, noun,
名词，生态系统。
We should protect the ecosystem of the beautiful wetland.
这湿地是很美的地方，我们需要保护它的生态系统。
Number 29, combine, verb,
及物动词，使结合，使联合。
This trip will combine education with recreation.
这旅程将会把教育与娱乐结合起来。
Number 30, innovation, noun,
名词，革新，改革，创新。
The innovation of air conditioning has made our life easier in summer.
冷气机的发明让我们的夏天时的生活容易多了。
Number 31, environment, noun,
名词，自然环境，生态环境。
Let's create an English-speaking environment for our students.
让我们替学生们创造一个英语学习的环境。
It's about the end of this chapter, but we still have a few minutes to talk about. In the last paragraph, we talk about it's a kind of a combined tradition, innovation, and science. Can we explain a little bit what kind of a tradition we are using here?
Tradition is that we grow kinds of crops according to the weather. Right?
Yes, we have to know the plants, their needs,
and
right?
The timing.
Timing. Yeah. And what do they need, the timing, mm-hmm. and how long will they grow, something like that.
Yeah.
And for the innovation?
For the information, we use
the ducks or the geese.
Yes, yes.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. And just keep those harmful things for farm.
Okay. Then mm-hmm. what do you mean here by science?
Science? They have to design, for example, they have to design certain kind of cover.
Okay, cover. Okay.
Yes, and to cover the farm.
That's true.
To prevent the pests or the bugs to come inside the farm.
Yes, and they have to do lots of experiments too.
Yes,
that's
right.
Part of the science. Students, we are so happy to have you here. Hope that you can learn more of organic farming and also you can visit some of the organic farms some other time to see it by yourself. So, students, see you next week.
See you.
See you.